Yeah, hi guys, welcome to our review of the TR50 or the HDR 50 cal revolver from Umarex. It's part of the T4E range. It's been out for quite some time. One of my favorite paintball products in recent years. I've been working in the industry and playing paintball for around about 12 years now. I mean, I don't always get excited about new releases. They're usually just variations of an old thought, an old design, but this is something completely new. Umarex stepped into the world of paintball, and this is what they've brought us. I mean, all their paintball stuff is branded under the T4E range, which is training for engagement, but we're playing paintball with it and we're looking at it in that context. I think depending on where you are in the world, it is sold as a home defense item, but I honestly think really it's better used on the paintball field. I think if you are going to be using it for home defense, one, it depends where you are on the legality of that. If you're, for instance, if you're in the UK, then it's a no-no. Other parts of the world, yeah, you could, but unless you're going to have a sort of invasion by squirrels, it's not really going to defend you against anyone breaking into your home. Paintball wise, it's a stunning piece of kit. Now we're looking at it's the TR50. You know, usually with this side of the pond, it would be the HDR, but the Americans, sorry, sounds like a bit of a dig, but you guys on the other side of the Atlantic, you tend to get the better deals. So if you are in the US, what you'll get in your package is you'll get this stunning piece of kit, the revolver, absolute beast of a thing. And you get four extra magazines. So come on, Umarex. Umarex Germany, start looking after us in Europe. Give us some more mags. So first things first, so the outside of the HDR or the TR50 is polymer. The internals are metal. Obviously, it's an air-powered paintball pistol. And to load and unload the magazine, it's quite simple. You've got a catch here that comes up. That comes out, and there's only one way you can put it in for its operating, and you can see that in the groove there. That goes into the groove there, so like so, release, ready to go. Now these have a slight advantage over the newer HDP 50 because they take 50 cal rubber rounds, 50 cal paintballs, but more excitingly, they take, I put this on my finger so the camera can see it. They take First Strike's new 50 cal First Strike. So that's a shaped projectile. It's like half a paintball, half shuttlecock. Flies further, flies straighter. I would say if you are using this for paintball, this is the ammo I would be putting into it. So to load it, it's really, really simple. You just push them into the chambers. Make sure you get it in the right way and it's good to go. So actually it's not good to go because I haven't put any CO2 on it. So it goes in this way, worth noting, not that way, this way, because your piercing, yeah, your puncture valve is here. So it just goes in, screws in a little bit, when it gets tight, you just tap in the bottom of that. CO2 is punctured and it's ready to go. And what you'll see is this little valve here will indicator will pop out, and you'll know it's loaded. And we've actually used an empty 12 gram for this demonstration, but what you would usually see is this would pop out. And that's also used for purging. So when you've got low, the CO2 is low, rather than trying to take this off of your fingers, which probably be about impossible, you press that, it purges all the air out of the system, and then you can easily undo that and reload. We did some shooting over the chrono, and it's a little bit all over the place. We were using the Virtue clock, which isn't ideal for 50 cal. But yeah, so between 250 and 280, which is plenty powerful enough for playing paintball with. The HDP was slightly higher than that. So if you're wanting a little bit, something that packs a little bit more punch, then maybe that's the one to go for. But this, for me, is probably the best paintball product we've seen come onto the market in a long time. I absolutely love this revolver. Can't find anything bad to say about it. So guys, thanks for coming to the end of this video and thanks for watching. Really, really appreciate it. And if you have liked this video, please give us a thumbs up. And if you want to see more content like this, then please hit the subscribe button. Thanks guys, bye now. Thank you.